designed specifically for. And here you have calcium voltage. So the thing to notice is that these, the calcium elevations occur before anything happens here. This is the base. This is the index. Okay, so I need to finish. When we try to model these things that we saw here with the current models that are available, we totally failed. And so in this recent paper that appeared in Chaos, what we did is we modeled a system using a modified Shannon-Poulidis covariance model, where the ryanodine receptor had three gates, an activation and an inactivation gate that are sensitive to cytosol and calcium, and an inner gate that is sensitive to luminal calcium. And when we're able to do that, I'm not going to show the movies, I'm running out of time, then you could actually generate a lot of the patterns that we saw here. And we think that that's an important thing to consider when you model, you're trying to predict experimental data in a way that lines up with what we're able to see and observe. These are model descriptions. And I don't know if I should even show this, but you tell me what this is.
This was in the second one. Can you describe again what this is?
I'm sorry?
What is the size of this field?
This is 150 by 150 microns. The subcellular field. And this calcium. And the heart is under fibrillation.
This is
I don't know how this happens. I certainly have no way to model that. Anyway, I want to show you the people who did the work. Opens back up. And in zones where
Because they affect other channels. I can go over the details. We are Into about the last talk, what it led into toward the end, because that's what the stuff. blessed with the opportunities to.
Yeah.
I'm not.